Hello, it's LMTX, an IoT advisor and trainer. Today, I will talk about the very important service, the AWS IoT Rules Engine. It allows you to get data from your devices, process them, and route to other AWS services not related to IoT core or even some external endpoints. Using this service, we can design and build fully serverless backends for our IoT applications. So, let's check how it is organized. This is our IoT device. It sends MQTT messages to IoT core on a given topic. We've got the IoT rule and action assigned with that rule. This is a sample topic. DT, which stands for data, smart farm, PL, which is the location, then we've got 001, which is ID of this specific farm, gate, and 2, which is the ID of a specific gate. And this is a sample message. So we've got status of our gate and time when that message was sent from device to our IoT core. Using AWS IoT Rules Engine, we can route that message to multiple destinations. Those are just a sample destinations that you can transfer the message to. For instance, we can invoke Lambda function, we can send this message to simple notification service, simple queue service, and others. Let's check how the rule action is organized. First, we've got a SQL query, then destination, and finally, a role used by this action. As a sample destination, we are going to use the SQS, because this is a good design pattern to send messages to queue, and from that queue, we can consume them, for instance, using Lambda function. Let's review a sample SQL query. This is how it looks. We select data from this topic, and as you can see, we are using a wildcard. That means that we want this action to be invoked for any gate. So the gate ID is plus. We select all data from this message, and we enrich it using this function. Topic 6 means that we are going to use the ID, which is at this level of MQTT topic, and add it as a gate ID to body of our message. So this is how the message stored in SQS is going to look like. But before our IoT rule can send any data to SQS, we need to allow it to do so. For that, we are using the IAM role. The IAM role establishes trusted relation with IoT core, so it can assume this role. It got the policy attached, and that policy allows to send messages to SQS. This is the full picture. We've got the IoT device that sends MQTT messages to the IoT core on a given topic. We've got IoT rule that listens on this topic and invokes this action if following condition is met. So in our case, if gate status is open, it will forward this message and reach it with gate ID and stores it in SQS. And it can do so because this is the IAM rule that allows it to invoke this action. I hope that was interesting for you. Let me know if you've got any questions. All the best. LMTX, the IoT advisor and trainer.